Hey everyone, thermal paste is kinda scary. I mean, it is just some sticky blue gunk, but some people online say the computer might overheat and explode if you use it wrongly. For what it's worth, that's actually not true. As a test, I removed all my thermal paste and ran my 12-core CPU through a bunch of stress tests without any major problems, but I'll discuss that more towards the end of this video. What I was originally going to say here is that if you need to remove your CPU cooler or heatsink for any reason, can you just put your old cooler back on without changing the TIM? Well, let's find out. I performed three tests here, the first being a no-change baseline test where I ran a number of stress tests on my computer as is. I then opened up my case, removed the CPU cooler, waited a few minutes and put the cooler back on. I then ran a number of stress tests again and recorded the CPU temps. For the final test, I then removed my case and removed the cooler again, and this time I wiped off the 2.5-year-old Noctua thermal paste with an isopropyl alcohol wipe. I waited for this to dry, and then I applied some freshly purchased Arctic MX4 paste. I put the heatsink back on and retested everything. The results were actually pretty interesting, but before getting to that, I wanted to discuss exactly what individual tests I ran and why. The first test was a simple idle test where I booted the computer up and I waited 5 to 10 minutes for everything to settle down. I waited because sometimes CPU usage and the temps will spike up to maybe 60 or 70 degrees Celsius during the initial startup process, so it's important to let things settle back down to a baseline first. I then recorded the CPU temperatures within HWinfo after waiting for 5 minutes. There's naturally many different CPU temperature stats that you could look at, and there's not really such a thing as a single CPU temperature rating because of how modern CPUs are designed. But I cross-referenced the HWinfo stat with Ryzen Master and other programs, and the CPU die average was probably the closest to the other programs. So this is the temperature value that I stuck to during this video. The next test that I did was gaming. I played Sniper Elite 5 at 4K with all graphical settings cranked up to max. This always heats my PC up, so it was a good real-world test. After this test, I then exited the game and I waited at least 5 minutes for the temperatures to settle back down before running Prime95, where I ran the small FFTs test. While there are some good alternatives to Prime95 nowadays, this is still a great stress test because CPU usage is always 100% during it. The final test I did was then to render a 4K video at maximum settings within Premiere Pro. This is actually one of the best real-world tests you can run, to be honest, because video rendering maxes out your CPU and also stresses some of the other components in your PC. So that's the full test they ran. I always kept the room temperature at just below 20 degrees Celsius too, to ensure consistency. But that's enough background, let's go on to the tests and test results. I built my computer at the very end of 2021 and used a Noctua cooler with thermal paste pre-applied, and this was the baseline test I wanted to test things out on. You know, can you remove a CPU heatsink 2.5 years on and then put it back on without changing the TIM? So after turning my computer on and leaving it to settle down, I then reset the HWinfo stats and I waited for 5 minutes. You can see the results on screen now, with the average temperatures at idle being 44 degrees Celsius. When gaming, they increased to 57 degrees on average, with a max of 73 degrees. And then they went decently higher in my other two tests, with Prime95 temps averaging at 69 degrees, with them then heading higher to 72 degrees during a Premiere Pro render. Temps did also spike at 85 degrees during a 4K video render, which surprised me a bit. That's quite high, to be honest, so it'll be interesting to dig into this a little bit later on. The next thing to do, of course, was to create chaos and fire, at least if you're listening to some people online. So I opened up my case, and I professionally removed the case fan from my beast of a CPU cooler. After using a long screwdriver, I was finally able to remove the heatsink, and you can see that the TIM is still in fairly good condition here. There appears to be a decent enough coverage on both the CPU and the heatsink, and it seemed to be fairly liquidy. I'm not sure if that's a word, but basically it wasn't hard and cracked. That's worth knowing, because if you were removing a decade-old CPU cooler and the thermal paste had dried out, your results may vary a little compared to the results that I'm about to show you in this video. Anywho, I put the cooler back on as carefully as I could, and then I put everything back together. I booted the PC back up, and again I waited 5 to 10 minutes for everything to settle down before resetting the HWinfo stats and started my idle test, which saw an average of 47 degrees Celsius, 3 degrees more than my baseline test. I'll compare both test results in a minute, but I wanted to quickly keep showing this graph to point out that now both Prime95 and Premiere Pro are averaging above 70 degrees. I saw higher peak temperatures at idle and also when gaming and in Prime95 too. So here's the two test results compared, and for clarity, I'm only showing the average temperatures here. As you can see, thermal temperatures are a little higher in this second test. However, it's not massively significant. It's not like removing the CPU cooler has led to thermal throttling or degraded system performance. The test ran through fine from a performance standpoint, and it's just that things were a degree or two higher than they were before. Now, you might be thinking, okay, great, I can remove my cooler and put it back on without worrying about the thermal paste. But that might not be the correct conclusion to draw here, which brings us on to our third test. So I opened up my case and I removed the CPU fan and heatsink, and then I started to remove the old Noctua thermal paste. Obviously you have to do this on both the CPU and the cooler base itself. I started off by using a bigger cloth wipe just to remove the majority of the paste, and then I switched on over to isopropyl alcohol wipes to remove any of the residue. I then put new Arctic thermal paste on it, and I usually prefer to put a bit too much on compared to not having enough paste. Then I got my Noctua cooler and attached it back on, and naturally I then put my computer back together and booted back up, and I waited 10 minutes. I then ran through all the usual tests, running at idle, then gaming in Sniper Elite 5, then maxing out the CPU in Prime 95, and finally rendering a 4K video in Premiere Pro. The detail is also on screen. Now, what's immediately clear here is that the temperatures are lower across the board. Idle temperatures are below 40 degrees Celsius, and none of the averages are above 70 degrees. Nice! The max temperature spikes were also lower than before, too. Here's the side-by-side comparisons, and they're interesting. The results are clearly lower after changing the thermal paste, compared to simply removing my cooler and then putting it back on without changing anything else. But what's also interesting here is that the new Arctic thermal paste is leading to better results generally than my baseline tests. I think I know why this is, and I'll discuss that in a second, but firstly I should point out that eagle-eyed viewers might have seen that my case fans have changed for this third test. This isn't actually the cause of the lower temperatures though. My previous case fans were high-quality fans, and they were working absolutely fine. I only swapped them out because I wanted a matching colour theme on all of my fans, and I wanted to also move to a quieter Arctic setup with a fan hub. Due to this new fan hub, my new case fans are actually running slower than in my old setup. So if anything, temperatures in this new test should have been higher than my baseline test, not lower. Okay, so at first these results surprised me, but I think I know why the temperatures actually dropped so much after changing the thermal paste. You might be thinking it's because the old paste was 2.5 years old, but my first ever video on this channel, on Techer Overwrite, actually reviewed my Noctua cooler, and in that test I tested out idle temperatures and also Prime 95 temps, and they were in line with my baseline test results here. In other words, my temperatures have been at this baseline level for 2.5 years straight. What I think actually happened is that the Noctua cooler is so big that it can be a bit clunky to install. You have to try and align it onto the support bracket screws, and then tighten them from above from a distance, which can be quite hard to do. It's easy to scuff the thermal paste a bit here because you sometimes need to actually move the cooler up and down a bit to get it properly onto the screw. Also, plugging the CPU fan onto the motherboard is really hard in this case due to having so little space between the case fans and the CPU cooler. I love this old case, but this is one downside of it for sure. I can remember back to when I originally built this case and I actually put the cooler on first, and then I tried plugging the case fan connector in and I couldn't quite reach the connector on the motherboard. So I then had to take the CPU heatsink off, I then connected the cooler fan, and naturally I then mounted the heatsink back on again. This might have also scuffed or disrupted the pre-applied Noctua thermal paste, of course. So it's entirely possible that due to some minor build mistakes that I made 2.5 years ago, my system has been running 5 degrees hotter on average than it otherwise should have been. Whoops. Less than it though. At least now my system is running as cool as it possibly can be, and CPU temps are less than 20 degrees above ambient temperatures, which is pretty good. Before wrapping up, I have a quick bonus view. During my test here, I had the crazy idea of removing the thermal paste completely and seeing what would happen. That's right, I ran my 12-core Ryzen CPU with 0 temp. Yeah, the results weren't great. I booted up my PC and immediately the fans went crazy. They were completely maxed out, they were making loads of noise. I then got into Windows and I launched HWinfo, and this was genuinely the face that I pulled. My temperatures were spiking all over the place, regularly hitting over 90 degrees Celsius max and averaging in the 80s when running my stress tests. Yes, I ran Prime 95 on my 12-core CPU with 0 thermal paste. Hashtag mad lad. If you wanted to see the comparison results, here they are. The short summary is, don't run your CPU without any thermal paste. I'll actually discuss this in detail in another video, which will appear up here somewhere when it's released in a few weeks' time. But for now, that wraps up this video. I hope you found it useful. If you did, please click the thumbs up button and please subscribe to see more videos like this. Thanks for watching.